Hi, in the previous video I did an analysis about the charging and power circuit of the Nintendo Switch. Today I will continue with the multi-part Nintendo Switch videos, and today I will focus on the Nintendo Switch Lite. In this video I will explain what the components are and where they are located on the main board of Nintendo Switch Lite. I will explain the meaning of the test points that are used and located on the main board. Next I will explain where the control signals are sent when you press on one of the buttons on the Nintendo Switch Lite. I will also explain what the pins are of the FPC connector, which connects the main board to the Joy-Con board with a ribbon cable. I have analyzed different data sheets, the circuit traces on the main board, and my personal experience with Nintendo Switches to make this video. If you find a mistake or have more information about a specific topic, please add your comment in the comment section. If you like my content and would like to see more of these type of videos, please subscribe to my channel to help this channel grow. So, let's start. The Nintendo Switch Lite has the following buttons. So we have the ZL button, we have the ZR button located on the back side. We have the L button, the R button, this is the minus button, the plus button, left stick, the ABXY buttons, right stick, home button, the capture button, the control pad, and we also have the volume button located on the side and the power button. This is the front side of the mainboard. All these components are located on the front side of the mainboard. This is the USB-C receptacle, so you connect your cable to this USB-C port. Then we have your battery connector. This is the FPC connector, 29 pins, so this connects the ribbon cable to the Joy-Con board. So in this region we have the backlight driver, and based on your setting for the backlight, it can deliver up to 17 volt, depending on your settings in the Nintendo Switch. The Wi-Fi and Bluetooth is located at this area. This is the main Wi-Fi IC, and these are the antenna connections. The square sticker is a fluid indicator, so when there is moisture on the mainboard, this indicator turns red. These two are the RAM memory. When you press your power button, that signal, the enable zero signal, can be measured at this test point. This is the LCD driver. It will generate a positive and negative voltage that will go to the LCD. The LCD screen needs the positive and negative power from the LCD driver to control the pixel or subpixels. It controls how many light it has to pass through to create a color. The crystal oscillator is located here. This FPC connector is for the game card reader and the headphone jack. This connector here is for the fan. This is the audio IC, the Realtek ALC5639. This connector here is for the touchscreen. So when you touch the LCD screen, the coordinates are transmitted to this IC. From there, it will go to the APU. This pad here is for the ZR button. This is a Joy-Con connector. This is a speaker connector. This is the NFC IC. This is the eMMC flash storage, where the firmware is located. And the brains of the Nintendo Switch Lite, also Nintendo Switch and the OLED versions, is this SoC from Nvidia. This is a secondary power management IC. This IC will generate 0.8 volt for the APU, and it also will be used for the two RAM modules. This IC will only turn on if the primary power management IC that is located on the backside tells it to turn on, and also the APU will send an enable signal to this power management IC to start generating the 0.8 volt. On the mainboard, there are a lot of round gold plated copper pads, and those copper pads are used for testing purposes. So in the factory, all those points are connected to check the health of this mainboard. And of course, they don't want us to know what all those test points means. But with some reverse engineering, I think I have analyzed most of those test points. The VBUS voltage from the USB-C receptacle comes at this test point. CC1 can be measured here. CC1 is a configuration channel that is used for power negotiation for the M92T36 IC. This pad is ground. Then we have the data differential pair. The data minus and data plus can be located here. The configuration channel 2 is also used for the power negotiation, goes to the M92T36 IC, it's located here. On this pad you can measure the voltage of the battery. The VBUS can also be measured here, and the difference with this VBUS is that this VBUS is located after the overvoltage protection, so the two MOSFETs. This pad is ground. So these two pads are for the serial data communication, so the clock signal and the data signal. Then you connect a ribbon cable that goes to the Joy-Con board. On the Joy-Con board there's also a Joy-Con connector connected, and those pins can be measured at these three pins and also at this pin. So this is the left Joy-Con connector, and those pins can be measured here and here. This pin is a TS1 and TS2. So this is the configuration of the temperature window for the charging IC, the BQ charging IC. At this location you can measure the 4.2 VSIS voltage. This voltage is being generated by the BQ charging IC. This pad here is the volume data pin. So when you press the volume, you can measure it here. This pin goes to the APU. So everything to the APU, I don't know what the meaning is, but you can check the health of the APU with this test point. At this test point, the enable zero signal comes in and it will go to the APU. From there, it will go to the primary power management IC located on the back. It's ground. So in this region, the 0.8 volt for the RAM and the APU is being generated. On the back side, there is a coprocessor located, an STM32 IC. All the pads with the name STM32, like this one, this one, this one, this one, this, this, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one here, this one here, will go to the coprocessor. The coprocessor is located on the back side, and that is this IC. This pad here will go to the game controller IC located on the back. This one also goes to the game controller IC. These two pads here, below the FPC connector for the game card reader and the audio jack. On these two pads you can measure the headphone channel 1 and channel 2, and this will go to this FPC connector and to the headphone jack. So when you press the plus button, the signal can be measured on this test point. The Joy-Con connector, the right Joy-Con connector, all those pins can be measured at this location. All the test points located near the touch control IC, you can measure the health of this controller IC. There's also an enable 1 interrupt signal that will go to the primary IC located on the back. I think this is used when you touch the screen, it will get out of sleep mode. So this enable signal will go to the primary power management IC. These pads here are ground. All those pads located here will go to the Wi-Fi IC. So this is a multi-layer PCB board, and all those pads will go to this IC. The signal on this pad will go to the primary power management IC. All those pads here are going to the APU. The pads near the SFC connector will go to this IC, so you can check the health of this NFC IC. This pin here is used for the detection of the SD card. So when you insert a SD card, the detection will be sent to this pin, and from here it will go to the APU. All these data lines for the SD cards will go directly to the APU. I will make a separate video with all the diode measurements for all those test points. These are the components on the backside of the mainboard. We have the home button located on the left top corner. These two components are the NFC antenna. These four pads are the ABXY button. This is the R button, this is the plus button. This is the 3.3 volt buck converter. This is the primary power management IC, it's the MAX77620. This primary power management IC is responsible for making different voltages, like 1 volt for the APU, 1 volt for the sound IC, 1.8 volt for the RAM, 1.1 volt for the RAM, and also delivers some other voltages to other devices. This chip here is an coprocessor. It's the STM32F03, and this IC is responsible for transferring the low speed signals like the control signals back to the APU. This is the anti-piracy IC, also called the game card controller. And this is the crystal that generates the clock signal for this controller. This is the M92T36 USB-C power delivery controller. And this IC communicates with the power supply. So the USB power supply is connected to this USB-C receptacle. And the CC1 and the CC2 pins are used for power negotiation. This is the charging IC, also known as the BQ24193. This IC is responsible for charging the battery and also for generating the VSYS power rail of 4.2 volt. These MOSFETs here are used for the overvoltage protection. So these MOSFETs are controlled by this M92 IC. We have the fuel gauge IC. It will calculate the percentage of the remaining capacity of the battery and it communicates back to the APU. This little resistor acts like a fuse to protect the circuit from high current. These two pads here are the speaker Joy-Con board pins 1 and 2. So the speaker that is on the Joy-Con board, the pin 1 and 2 can be measured here. These are the test points located on the main board on the back side. This test point goes to the LCD driver connector. So the test point of the LCD driver connector goes somewhere here. This test point here goes to the SD card reader detect switch. So the signal of this pin goes to this test point. Then we have pin 1 and 2 of the speaker that's located on the main board. So the speaker on the main board, pin 1 and 2, goes into those two pads. These two test points goes to the APU. These three pads goes to the NFC IC. So this is the NFC IC. This test point goes to the Joy-Con pin number 5 on the main board and also on the Joy-Con board. So pin 5 is located here. And on the Joy-Con board, the pin 5 of the Joy-Con connector is located here. This test point goes to the touch controller IC. The touch controller IC is located here on the front side. The power button signal, so the enable zero signal, can also be measured at this diode, at this location. On those two pads, we can measure the AC OK signal. And this signal comes from the charger IC on pin 3. So here's the charger IC. So on pin 3, the circuit traces go also to these two locations. These two test points are for the LCD driver. So on one pad, it will be the positive boost channel drain, so the positive voltage. And on the other test point, the LCD driver is the min boost channel drain, also known as the inverted channel or the negative power. I don't know what these two test points are. The test point here, this one, and this one will go to the sound IC. This pad will go to the APU. This is the ground pad. And the STM32, pin 44, and the reset pin will go to the STM coprocessor. So this is the coprocessor. On this pad, the input of the microphone can be measured. This is the ground pad. On this pad, I think there is a power rail. I don't know which one it is. This pad here goes into the game card controller IC. All those pads here will go to the Wi-Fi IC. These two pads will go to the speaker that's located on the Joy-Con board, so pin 1 and 2. This is the speaker connector located on the Joy-Con board. And this is pin 1 and 2. So these two pins goes to these two test pads. And from here it will go to the audio IC on the other side. It's for the reset signal that comes from the APU and it goes to this M92 IC. This pad here is used for the VCON in, so it will be delivering 5 volt for the VCON connection. On this test point here, you can measure the backlight IC, the switch pin, so the power that's generated for the backlight can be measured on this test pad. On this pad, you can measure the battery voltage. This test pad here is used for the TS1 and TS2 temperature window that is used in this charging IC. This pad here is used as an external voltage. And this voltage is used by the M92 IC. These two pads here are used for the data signals, the differential pair of the USB signals. So D- and D+ can be measured here, but it will eventually go directly into this APU. This test point here is used for the backlight IC, pin 3. So I think it is a current feedback pin number 1 on the backlight IC. The backlight IC is located here. When you press the power button, the enable 0 signal can be measured at this resistor on the top side. And on the other resistor, you can measure the volume button signal. This testbed here is from the temperature pin of the battery connector, so the middle pin. And that will go into the fuel gauge IC. This pad here will go to the Wi-Fi IC. This is ground, and this is the V-bus that comes from the power supply. So these four pads are going to the Wi-Fi IC, and I think this one is used for the JTAG interface. And the other ones are general purpose input outputs, and what the meaning of that is, I don't know. I made a separate video that goes in depth about this circuit, and you can find it in my playlist on my channel. This charging and power circuit is basically the same for the Nintendo Switch Lite. And the BQ IC is responsible for charging the battery and also for generating the VSYS signal. And the M92 is responsible for the power negotiation. So if it wants 15 volt at 1 amp to be used in the console, it will send communication back to the power supply via the CC1 and CC2 lines. And the power supply will start delivering 15 volt, 9 volt or 5 volt, depending on what is negotiated. The fuel gauge IC is used to calculate the remaining capacity in the battery. And this data is sent back to the APU. And the APU will transfer it back to the screen on the right top corner. The middle pin is a temperature pin or the battery detection pin. And if this battery is overheating, this temperature will be sent to the fuel gauge IC. And if it is critical, it will send an alert signal back to the APU, and APU will turn the console off. And as you can see, all the ICs are communicating with the APU by a serial connection. And also, if the charging IC is working okay, it will send its charge status back to the APU and a power good or AC okay signal back to the primary power management IC. So this is a very short explanation. If you want to know in depth how this works, you can check this video out. I will now focus on the coprocessor. So this coprocessor is responsible for the low speed signals from the buttons. This is the coprocessor. On pin 1, there's the power supply coming in. All the button signals will eventually go into this IC, and this IC will communicate with the APU. The signals for the power button and the volume buttons will go directly to the APU, but all other signals from the buttons that you press are going eventually to this IC. So on pin 2 and pin 3, the right button and the L button comes in. This comes from the Joy-Con board. This is the right button and this is the L button. So these two signals will go into those two pins. The signal from the top button will go onto pin 4. This is the top button. The signal of the left button will go to pin 10. This is the left button. This is the down button. And this signal will go onto pin 11. Pin 12 is used for the X button. And the X button is located on one of those pads. The signal of the B button will go to pin 13. The B button comes from one of those four pads. On pin 14, 15 and 16, those are the pins that comes from the Joy-Con that is located on the Joy-Con board. This is the Joy-Con connector on the Joy-Con board. So on pin 1, 3 and 4, those signals will go to the coprocessor. Those signals will go to pin 14, 15 and 16. On pin 17, 18 and 19, that's the Joy-Con connector pin 1, 3, 4. That is the connector that is located on the main board. So this is the Joy-Con connector on the main board. So pin 1, 3 and 4 will go to the coprocessor. It will go to pin 17, 18 and 19. On pin 29, the plus button signal comes in. So the plus button signal will go to pin 29. The minus button will go to pin 35. So the signal of this minus button will go to pin 35. The signal of the capture button will go to pin 36. Pin 38 and 39 are for the Y button and the A button on the mainboard. Pin 40 and 41 are for the ZR button and the R button also on the mainboard. And the last one, pin 45, is the ZL button located on the Joy-Con board. So the signal of the ZL button goes to pin 45. This is the mini Joy-Con board, the front side, and this board is connected through a ribbon cable back to the mainboard. And on this mini Joy-Con board, the buttons are located, so the minus button, right button, left button, top button, down button, the capture button and the L button. All those signals will go to the coprocessor. So this is the backside of this mini Joy-Con board. This is the cable connector, so the ribbon cable will go back to the mainboard. This is a speaker, this is the left Joy-Con. This is the backlight connector, the power and volume connector. I think this is the power line. This is volume plus or minus. This is a ZL button and the L button. So pin 2 is a switch pin that will deliver max voltage of 17 volts to drive the backlight LEDs. Pin 3 is the current feedback one that will go to the backlight driver IC. And 4 is ground. The ribbon cable that is connected to this cable connector of 29 pins. This ribbon cable will go back to the mainboard. So the ribbon cable that comes from the Joy-Con board connects into this connector. And this connector is located on the mainboard. So the cable connector on the mainboard is located here. And I made a breakdown of each pin. Pin 15 is ground. Pin 14 is the capture button, left button on pin 13. 12 is the ground. These pins here, pin left 10, right 11, are the speaker pins 2. And the pin left 9, right 10, are the speaker's pin 1. So pin 1 and 2 of the speaker connector will go to these two pins and these two pins. On 9 we have the ground. On 8 is the top button. 7 is the L button. 6 is the Joy-Con pin number 3. R5 is the down button. R4 is Joy-Con pin 5. On 3 is Joy-Con pin 4. And R2 is Joy-Con pin 1. And the last pin is the ground. These are the pins on the right side of this connector. On the left side, we have on pin 1 the ground. Pin 2 is the ZL button. Pin 3 is the minus button. Pin 4 is the volume button. Pin 6 is the power enable signal. Pin 7 is the right button. Pin 8 is ground. These two are the speaker pins. Pin 11 is ground. Pin 12 is the switch pin that comes from the backlight IC. So the max voltage of 70 volt goes to this pin. On pin 14 and 13, the current feedback 1 and 2 will go back into the backlight IC. I also analyzed the test points. So these two pins are the serial connection pins. So the clock signal and the data signal. These three test points are used for the Joy-Con connector pins 5, 4, 3 that's located on the Joy-Con board. This is the temperature pin of the middle pin of the battery connector. This is the VBUS line, this ground. On this pin you can measure the minus button, the ZL button, the down button, the right button, top button, L button, left button and the capture button. And in diode mode you can compare these with known good values. And then you know what the meaning is of each test point. These test points are located on the backside. This pad is used for the volume button and it goes directly to the APU. This is also for the volume, goes also back to the APU and this one. These four pads will go directly to the APU and this will also go to the APU. On this test point and pad, the enable signal of the power button can be measured. These three pads will go to the APU. All these pads and test points will also go to the APU. These two pads will go to the coprocessor on pin 42 and 43. VCS can be measured on those two pins. This is ground. These two are not connected and this is also ground. This is the Joy-Con connector located on the Joy-Con board. The signal for pin 1 will go to pin 14 of this coprocessor. Pin 3 will go to pin 16 of the coprocessor. Pin 4 will go to pin 15 of this coprocessor. and pin 5 will go to the ribbon cable connector on the main board, and that's the right pin number 4. This is the Joy-Con connector on the main board. This is pin 1, 3, 4 and 5. So pin 1 will go to pin 19 of this coprocessor. Pin 3 will go to pin 17 of this coprocessor. And pin 4 will go to pin 18 of this coprocessor. And pin 5 can be measured on this transistor. The transistor is located here near the game card connector. In the next video, I will show how the backlight LCD driver circuit, the audio circuit and the game card reader is implemented in the Nintendo Switch Lite. If you like this video and want to see more, then don't forget to give a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button for more in-depth circuit analysis. Thank you for watching, until next time, bye bye.